I was checking with them on whether, you know, this session has gone on for too long and should we give the audience a break. Also, no, we're running behind time, so we need to continue. So I'll try and make it as entertaining as possible for you. I don't have a film to show. But, you know, these are some honest thoughts. You know, yesterday as I was putting this presentation together, I looked at the list of speakers and I realized that actually we have a good number of hardcore marketers presenting. So I thought, let me then, you know, take a few steps back and talk about how I see this whole conversation that we've been having today about television. My marketing journey started on campus. And you know, the faces that you see there of these kids, this is the kind of excitement and joy that I faced when I was told about this great gentleman, Mr. Philip Kotler. I was told everything about segmenting, targeting, positioning. I was told it's all about making amazing creatives. And you know, toward the end of this book, actually, if you have read, how many of you have read this book, by the way? Just getting a pulse of the audience here. Towards the end of this book, there's a small chapter which says return on marketing investment. Have you read that? It was like a footnote. Yeah. And even my professor, he, in fact, you know, just 24 hours before our final semester, when I was doing my MBA, he said, by the way, just read through this chapter as well. Basically, you have to ensure that there's a good return on marketing investment that you need to make. So we also kind of wasted everything. Yeah. This is all about, you know, marketing, of course. There's no limit to money that is available because that's the right thing to do. And then I got into the companies. I started my career with ITC, then I worked in Unilever for 14 years. Then I was working with Jubilant Foodworks, which handles Domino's and Dunkin' Donuts. And right now with Cipla Healthcare. The biggest shocker that I got in my professional journey was actually this Mr. CFO. Because I could never understand, you know, irrespective of how amazing a campaign I was planning, I would go to him and say, ye campaign run karna hai. His immediate response would be, why do you need 40 crores for this? It's just telling stories to consumers, right? Bring it down to 20. I would go to him with a 20 crore campaign, he would say, bring it down to 5. So I would never understand what's wrong with this guy. Why does he not understand the real glitzy world of marketing? You know, now I've actually become saner in the last 17-18 years of work that I've done, and I've realized that actually, marketing budget is not the best use of money for the company. The company that I run, it needs to deliver a top line and EBITDA. Yeah. Now, after we have planned for the top line, there are a few costs that you of course need to pay for, right? You need to pay for people in the setup. Salaries have to be paid, otherwise we will run the company. So that's an essential cost. You also need to run, you know, spend a few other spends. So you need to of course ensure that the stock reaches the consumers. You need to pay for the depots. You need to pay for sales promotions, last minute sales promotion, because you have to deliver the top line. So there are some mandatory spends that you need to do which you cannot live without. And then the third head is A&P. Yeah, and the way the finance guys look at it is, oh right, so you want to sell stories, let's keep some money there. So in fact, in many situations, I have seen that the A&P money is a balancing figure in this P&L. Yeah, from top line to EBITDA, which are the two deliverables, you pay for the balance costs, which are mandatory, and whatever is left is the A&P whether that comes. Now, for organizations which actually think like this, I don't think they are being, you know, behind the times. I think the problem there is that the marketing fraternity inside those setups has not managed to convince the right stakeholders about what marketing does for them. Yeah, and hence for me, for a marketer to truly survive in today's world, return on marketing investment is an absolute must. Without that, you will always struggle for these spends. And hence, the way I define business objectives for the setup that I run, I need to deliver physical reach, mental reach, and I need to ensure that these are delivered profitably. Yeah. So for every brand, while the adequate physical reach is done, you understand physical reach? Physical reach is that the product has reached all the right stakeholders. Mental reach means that the brand is sitting in the head of the right stakeholder, the right memory structure, the right understanding of the brand sits amongst the right consumers. Once these two objectives are met and they will be met profitably, the job is done. This calls for a great company. What does this mean for a marketer in the company? What it means for a marketer is that we all need to deliver amazing mental reach and we have to do that profitably. Yeah. So the reach that we deliver should not be ahead of the budget that have been planned. Because reality strikes all the time, reality strikes every quarter and every year when it comes to the funds which are available. Now, some of you might be thinking, saying, "Arey, ad dikhao yaar, this is a
It's sort of a marketing get together. What boring things are you talking about? But you know, if you actually look at some of the obvious facts, so this is essentially three essential parameters that all of us think about, and all the creative ones actually think of loyalty, right? We think of the fact that the most loyal consumers are the ones that you need to speak with. We have to decide on the right segment of the market that you need to speak to, and let's talk to them again and again and again. But reality is the last point, which is the penetration. It's the penetration that drives volume growth. It's not loyalty that drives volume growth. It's not the right pricing that drives volume growth. Over a period of 3 years, it's actually penetration driven of the product that delivers volume growth for a setup. Yeah. And the second other interesting chart, you know, these are some of the top brands that exist in the market today. If you actually see, 40 to 80% of shoppers or consumers who buy these brands buy them only once or twice a year. So it's not the loyal consumers who are driving these businesses. It's the disloyal consumers who buy these brands once or twice a year who are driving these businesses. They come, they go, they jump around multiple brands, but these are the real guys that you need to speak to. So for every winning business, if you have to succeed, you need to ensure that you whisper to many instead of shouting to a few. Yeah, that's the mantra, that's the core of the message that I want to land. Stop trying to shout to a 4Q loyal consumers again and again and again. A better task to do would be whisper to multiple consumers. You'll end up getting a better bang for the buck for your money. Yeah, so hence, in a nutshell, for me, the media task, once the creatives are done, and of course, you know, whether it is about salience, whether it's about persuasion, that's the objective of the brand. Eventually, the essential media task for everyone is about delivering maximum possible unduplicated reach. That's the task to be efficient and effective in terms of returns on marketing. Now, when you look at television in that context, and you know, these are, Madison has helped us with some of these numbers, and actually some of the charts you might see being common as well, that this explains how closely we work with our media agencies as we run the businesses. So, you know, if you work to just do television, unduplicated reach delivered by television maximum gets you up to 70%. Yeah. You then latch on all other media vehicles that are available, it takes you to 86%. What it essentially means is that beyond television, delta that you add as a sum of all the other medium is only 16%. Yeah. And the cost that you pay for this is significantly higher. And hence, the idea should be to first hit this 70% and then look at other mediums that you need to add on to be efficient in your spend. And this is an example of, you know, one of the campaigns that we had planned, where we said that, you know, for 1.75 crore that we have, and it's a small couple of months plan, we said that, you know, the best use of this 1.75 crore is actually spend 1.55 on television, put another 20 lakhs on digital, and that gets you the best possible efficient whispering campaign. And this whispering campaign will have the maximum ROMI for us as a setup for that brand. Sam spoke about decay and the fact that, you know, there is a big halo effect. These are some examples of a halo effect of television. So as you run a television campaign, and these are examples of some of our brands, you actually see that the search volume on you know, digital completely moves in sync with the quantum of GRPs that are being flunked on television. Same is true for the quantum of downloads that you have for any asset that you want consumers to download as a part of your digital campaign. And you know, for some of us, of course, you would have heard of this latest buzz around saying, you know, the real engagement medium is actually digital. Yeah, television, you know, there is a lot of distraction. Fact remains, is one of the surveys that we had gotten conducted, almost 60% of consumers actually say that I expect to find the most emotional advertising on television. So for a consumer as well, in the heart of his heart, he or she believes that television is the medium where I would actually be connecting with a brand emotionally, and not rest of the mediums. If you actually see, social media sits at 9%. You know, talk of the multiple hours of engagement that we do, we talk about on digital medium, it actually sits at 1/7 or 1/8 of television here. AdX revenue is close to 37-38%. I heard a few speakers talk about it as well. So for me, honestly, this actually should be at least 60%. And only at 60%, I would say that we are making the most of the money that are being spent on media vehicles. This is a very interesting chart for me, you know, and this takes me back to Amazon and Flipkart as they were setting up operations in India. And I was, and as a Unilever marketeer, I was involved in some of those conversations. And the logic that they used to talk about when they were setting up business in India was about saying, a guy online is the best guy to catch to bring him to our e-com site, because anyone who is offline, usko yaar convince karna, then for him to actually come onto our site will take a lot of effort. So they started their campaigns with heavy burst on online media campaigns. And they very quickly realized that it was not working. So it worked for the early adopters, but they realized that if they had to actually build a skill, they had to go to television as a medium. The right-hand chart actually shows you that, and the maybe it's not very readable for you guys, the brands here are Amazon, Google, Flipkart, Paytm, Swiggy. These are some of the largest, online brands as well. You actually see that, and the chart on the right actually shows you the percentage of mass media spend and the percentage of television contribution to their mass media spend. You actually see that even brands like Amazon and Flipkart have as much as 60-70% of their spend on television. Because they also realize, and you look at how this whole chart is moving up over the last 4-5 years, it's just showing that it is delivering efficiency for them, and they are latching onto it, and they are increasing the contribution year after year. The one on the left shows absolute TV spends that these guys have done. And the guy on the top is the guy who we all say understands analytics the best, which is who? Amazon. Look at the quantum of spend that Amazon has plonked on television, clearly seeing honestly, if you ask me, from my experience, the closest, the best analytics engine that exists in this country at least, and also globally, actually is Amazon. And if they do something and if you were to track it closely, it shows you the logic behind it. And they see that they need to spend at least 70% of their money on television today to deliver maximum effectiveness of medium. So, you know, if Amazon does it, must be the right thing to do. There's other argument that one keeps hearing about the fact that, you know, millennials are, they don't watch television. That's not a fact. 1/3 of share of eyeballs on television still belongs to millennials. The other fact is that 3 to 4 hours of TV viewing time is what millennials today do. 3 to 4 hours. That's a big number, right? And the fact that, you know, of course, you have to ensure that the content is right. You also need to ensure that the genre that you are using to catch these guys is the right one. Of course, you have to appeal to their taste. But the fact remains that if you do the right set of creatives and activations on television, even for millennials, that's the best thing to, television is the best medium to go for. A few examples closer home. Now I'm coming to Cipla Health. Nicotex, how many of you have heard of Nicotex? Oh wow. And how many of you are smokers? Awesome. So we have a few smokers. So Nicotex is the market leader in smoking cessation. We have close to 95% share of the market, 85% with Nicotex, another 10% with Nicogum. These two brands together 95% share. This is a very interesting chart. If you actually look at the yellow curve, that's our market share, and the blue bars are TV spends, absolute TV spends that we have done. So if you actually look at the dip that we saw, is when we went purely digital for 3 to 6 months. And then as we started to build ad stock, you see that the share has started to climb. You know, so one of the things that we have learned the hard way is not take your hands off television, because that's super critical. You have to hold it to ensure that the narrative stays as it is supposed to be, to ensure continuity. A very different brand, Coxel. How many of you have heard of Coxel? Awesome. Great stuff. Damo, where are you? People have heard of the brand. So, Coxel is one of the largest cough and cold brand that we sell. Highly competitive category, but again you see similar trends. So the red one is your total share. The yellow one is total share. The red ones are the digital spends, and the blue bars are the TV spends. Again, you see a clear correlation. We have hit one among the highest shares over the last 3 to 6 months, clearly driven by ad stock building up over the last 6 to 12 months. So we ensure that we don't take our hands off television, and we ensure continuity there. The share starts to build up as well. So today, as you know, these are the brands that we sell today. So we are in smoking cessation, we are in pregnancy care, we've just launched Mama Expert as a brand, we have energy drinks, Prolite is a brand that we've gone live with, we are in multivitamins with Maxirate as a brand, Nasmine, which is a cold brand, Active Kid, which is an interesting kids nutritious chocolate, and then we are in pain care, which is one of the largest pain care brands in the country by the name of Omnigel. The medium has just broken live, it's one of the largest brands without any communication done so far. So the idea is now we get aggressive on communication and start to build this brand as well. So for all these brands, our net mantra is we will use TV heavily. And the simple math is, arithmetic is that for a brand which plans to spend something like 2 to 5 crores, television is not the best thing to do. Because you're creative, making the creative and, you know, paying the agency and all of that. No offense meant to agency sitting here, but those are real spends that, you know, we need to pay for. That itself eats a lot of money. So then you of course do digital and other media. So beyond 4 to 5 crores per year, TV is the way to go. Maximize television, whisper to many about your brand, you will get great returns. And after that, top it up with the right medium for the right states and geographies based on priorities. So those are my learnings for you. Thank you so much.